Hey guys, in this new video, we're going to continue with our discussion on calculations dealing with Gibbs free energy, but now look at it under non-standard conditions. So, in example one, it says, calculate delta G of reaction. You'll notice that there isn't a small circle on top, meaning that this is under non-standard conditions. So, calculate delta G reaction at 25 degrees Celsius under the conditions shown below for the following reaction. Here I tell you delta G under standard conditions is 31.6 kilojoules. Now we know we're dealing with non-standard conditions here, so it's going to be delta G equals delta G zero plus RT ln Q. Now, what you need to remember is that Q is our reaction quotient and it equals products over reactants. It ignores solids and liquids. Luckily, neither one of these compounds is a solid or a liquid, so we're going to look at both of them. So we're going to say Q here equals Cl3. The coefficient is a 2. That 2 means this is going to be the power now. Divided by Cl2, its coefficient is 3, so its power will be 3 as well. The partial pressures of Cl2 and Cl3 are given as these numbers respectively, so those are the values we're going to plug in. So Cl3 is 4.9 squared. Cl2 is 0.83 cubed. When we plug this in, it gives us 41.9912. So that's what our Q equals. So we're going to say now delta G is 31.6 kilojoules plus 0.008314 kilojoules over Kelvin times moles. Time here will have to be in Kelvin, so add 273.15 to our 25 degrees Celsius. That gives us 298 Kelvin. And then ln of 41.9912. When we plug all that in, so we're gonna do ln of 41.9912 times 298.15 times 0.008314 plus 31.6. When you do all that, that gives you 40.86 kilojoules. So what we can say about this reaction, it is highly non-spontaneous. Because remember, if your delta G is greater than zero, it's a non-spontaneous reaction.